Good afternoon. Good afternoon, especially students. It's wonderful to see you here, and welcome to the celebration marking this week's free ride launch for St. Petersburg College's students. I am Karen Kaufman White, provost of this beautiful, warm St. Petersburg Gibbs campus. Transportation is very important to our students. It's this ticket that makes the difference for their education. For some of our students, this ticket will mean the difference in coming to college and not coming to college. We are so very grateful for this partnership. You're going to hear more about it as the program goes on. There will be other introductions as we go along. But we have been working for and hoping for and working for easy access to bus service for our students for a very, very long time. Among those on the stage behind me are the college president, a senior vice president, several provosts, people from the community and from the board of PSTA that you will meet, all of whom support you and your academic endeavors. This is just one small piece, but we know it's an important one. And here we are. We thank you for being here to help us mark this day. Please join me in not only welcoming, but also thanking PSTA CEO Brad Miller.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I just got to tell you one story quickly. I have worked at a lot of transportation systems around the country, and before I came here, I worked in Des Moines, Iowa, and we had an event with a university in a very similar kind of program with Drake University, which is there, and we had an event like this, and the weather was 25 degrees below zero for this exact same event there, and it's about 125 degrees today, I know, so we will be very brief. I am so happy to be here and thankful for St. Pete College. This is a fantastic win-win program, and let me tell you about that. First of all, PSTA is a bus system that is very well-run and very efficient, and one of the things we rely on very heavily is passenger fares. Because more than a quarter of all of our costs are paid for by the riders who ride our services. So we rely on that. However, we know that many people maybe don't ride the bus because they don't know the fare or don't understand, or that might be an inhibitor. And so when St. Pete College agreed to pay the fares on behalf of their already many riders, the students that ride, it couldn't be a better deal. All students, all 32,000 or more students that are enrolled in St. Pete College campuses around the entire county, as of Monday, are riding for free. And that is a great deal. We have already seen very huge increases in ridership already. As I'm sure you'll hear again, this is a great benefit for both PSTA and for St. Pete College. Of course, one of the major ways we can improve our economy here in Pinellas County is by getting more people to get advanced degrees. And this is a way that saves you money, saves students money, saves the college money, and grows our economy. If you get an advanced degree, you can get a better job, and that helps all of us. But it's a way that folks can save up to $9,000 a year by not having to operate a car. It can save in parking. Parking certainly seems to be limited here, and I know at the other campuses, and that'll be a great thing. You probably have heard a little thing that's going on this November called Greenlight Pinellas. It's a vote to improve public transit substantially in Pinellas County. This is a great program, this UPass deal, and students are riding for free already in big numbers. But one of the main issues, and I've talked, this is the number one thing I hear from students when talking to them, is the service is limited. The service is limited here to Gibbs campus. It's limited to Seminole campus and others. And sometimes there's quite a bit of a walk, or sometimes the buses just don't run at the same times that the classes run, especially late at night. That's what the Greenlight Pinellas plans first things will do, is change that dramatically, running every route till at least 10 o'clock. during when the classes operate, so even more students can take advantage of that. So that's something to think about in the future. For now, I am very happy to see you guys wearing your t-shirts, and I will see you on a bus, I'm sure, soon. I want to quickly introduce and offer them a chance to say something. Two of my my 15 board members that I report to on the PSTA board. First, County Commissioner Ms. Janet Long, and then second, St. Pete City Councilman Wengay Newton.
Good afternoon, students. Thank you, Brad. Students, most especially, I am excited to be here this afternoon to celebrate this initiative with all of you, because at the end of the day, what we are really talking about here is changing the culture of our county. It's not just about giving you an opportunity to get back and forth to school, but when you get out of school, you'll be able to travel to your job, and you'll be able to get where you're going and get back home, even if you're coming home later in the evening or on the weekends. You'll be able to go to the movies with your friends and go shopping at the mall. And in the not too far distant future, you'll be able to go right from Pinellas County to Tampa International and downtown Tampa as well. So it really is about the future, and having you and your friends and your colleagues at your age embrace this now will save you thousands and thousands of dollars later on when you get into your careers, because you won't be so dependent on buying gas, buying an automobile, and paying for car insurance. So encourage your friends, use the buses, use the trolleys, use the connectors. The more you do, the more successful we'll be. Go green light. And for those of you that have not yet registered to vote, please get yourself registered, and please study this initiative really, really well, and think about what it will do for you and for the future of this county. Thank you for being here.
Okay. Well, I got to get my selfie because you guys should see what I see. Okay, we're good. The bad part about having staff hand out talking points is they hand the same sheets out and Brad stole all of my fun. But I got to speak in your language. You'll be able to save $9,000 in ramen noodles. So what I'm saying. Also, what it really offers is transportation options. Just last month, the city of St. Pete, the city I represent, signed a partnership with PSTA, and now our 2,800 employees can ride for free just by showing their IDs. And that's a cool thing, because it takes a lot of the stress off of you. If you get up and your car is not acting right, or you got a flat tire, you don't have a car. The bike has a flat tire. You got options now. Also, on these buses, they're cool. They're designed for the millennials. We also have Wi-Fi. Say it with me, Wi-Fi. Yes. So it could be a more productive commute for you, because as you commute back and forth from school to work, if it takes you an hour each way, that's 2 hours. You're never, ever going to get back. So you might as well enjoy it. But I'm here to help with this partnership. I'm glad Dr. Law and his staff saw fit to provide this for you guys. You know, this is great. I mean, my son attends St. Pete College, and I don't really pay no high car insurance and no car payments. So, but don't tell him that. But he works for the city, so he get the best of both worlds. But hopefully you guys will go out, you enjoy it, tell everybody, Facebook about it, tweet about it. And we also have this initiative coming up. You heard about Greenlight Pinellas in November. It's on the ballot. It's way, way down the ballot. So you have to focus. And if you're not registered to vote, like Commissioner Long said, go out and register to vote. It's important. This is all about you. I think the best thing we could have did with this transit initiative was have it available 10 years ago. Because not just for the young people that are attending school, but look at your parents and your grandparents. And when it comes to that pivotal time when you have a conversation about how do we take the keys away, you know, what do we do? Because when you do, you got to start driving around and doing all that stuff too. But for now, it's about you guys. It's about transportation options. Like I said, it's about later running buses. And we currently have a 300 bus, 300X, that goes downtown Tampa today, so you don't have to wait until November. But you'll be able to ride back and forth, and it's all because of the partnership from the school leadership here at the college and the PSTA. Thank you.
I just want to, again, just introduce us, really the leader at St. Pete College. I want to thank all of them, but Dr. Jim Oliver from the provost of the Seminole campus really was instrumental in launching this partnership.
Thanks, Brad, and everyone. I am Jim Oliver, the provost of the Seminole campus, and it's a pleasure to be here to talk about this partnership this afternoon. And it's my pleasure to begin by introducing two students to talk about the impact that this arrangement agreement has with our students. First, Jonathan Jock, a sophomore on the Seminole campus, and then Aretha Canyon, a St. Petersburg College Collegiate High School senior right here on this campus. We'll start with Jonathan.
Thank you, Dr. Oliver. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jonathan Jacques, and I am a sophomore student at SPC Seminole Campus, and I'm also the SGA president of Seminole Campus. It's hard to believe that I'm standing here today representing the students celebrating this wonderful agreement we have with PSTA. It's ironic also because I never would have been part of student government if it wasn't for PSTA. Because before, the student government purchased monthly bus passes for students for transportation issues, and that's how I got involved. I went to the Student Life Leadership Office, and Miss Milena got me a monthly bus pass and also got me involved on campus. It's thanks to her that I became more involved, the president, and helped push this initiative to get the agreement. This plan makes so much sense. I mean, the PSTA gets riders, and we get to transport. All we have to do is show our student ID. This addresses the concerns students have had for years. During the past spring, Dr. Oliver met with CEO Brad Miller of PSTA and County Commissioner Janet Long, principally to discuss concerns students have had about the bus service, of the lack of service in the mid-afternoon, nights, and weekends. The topic of universal bus passes came up parallel to the programs we have with Microsoft and BayCare, meetings with the Student Life Leadership Coordinators and Student Government Presidents followed. The student government presidents, they were enthusiastic about this this endorsement, and they supported it with the student fees to support this bus program. The additional benefit to this, all SPC faculty and staff can also ride the bus for free. And now here we are on this bright day to cut the ribbon. This is a great day for all students of the college, and hopefully it signals a new era for the bus service for our growing campuses. I'd like to thank my fellow students for championing this cause even before I became a student, and to all my peers, the SPC administration, and the PSTA officials for making it happen. Thank you.
Afternoon, everybody. I am Aretha Canyon. I'm a senior at the Collegiate High School here on the St. Pete College Gibbs campus. And when somebody told me that we get to ride on PSTA for free with just a flash of our ID cards, I didn't believe it. I was like, no, you're lying. This isn't real. And then it come Monday, and somebody gets on the bus and flashes their ID card and just goes take a seat. And so it's like, wow, this is reality. This is real. And now I get to do the same thing. And as a consistent PSTA depender, like I depend on these services, I used to ride it all last year, sophomore year. I needed this bus route the bus system. And to be that consistent rider, this means so much to me. I mean, first and foremost, since last year, I mean, the collegiate students did receive a weekly bus pass, but if you forgot to go to the office and get it, you were kind of stuck, and it was very inconvenient having to go to the parents and ask for money, like, Mom, Dad, please, I missed it this one time, I'll get it next week. And this summer, I was taking classes on the Clearwater campus for study abroad, and I live all the way over here, going to the Clearwater campus. I had to beg my parents, so they had to take time off work to drive me all the way to Clearwater and come back to get me because I didn't have the fare to get on the bus. And With this new policy, it lifts the burden of not having vehicular access off of the backs of SPC students. Because all of us don't have cars. The collegiate students I know, like some of us don't have permits or licenses, so we can't get there, or we just don't have cars. So this works perfectly for us, and no more trying to figure out what we're going to do, how we're going to get our rides, no more having to pay for bus fare. And on top of that, we get to use it 7 days a week. We get to go to the mall on the weekends. Woo! Like, oh, thank you. Thank you so much. In closing, this policy means no more awkward fumbles at the front of the bus trying to scrounge for my money in my wallet. I can just flash that shiny blue ID card and take my seat, and the bus driver goes, yeah, go take a seat, yeah. Thank you. And I want to say thank you, PSTA and SPC, for this grand opportunity, and you can be sure that I will utilize it to the fullest. Thank you.
Pretty tough to follow. The students did a great job. This is what good public policy looks like, providing for an easily understood, easily administered program where PSTA gets the riders and students know they have a way to get to school every day without having to worry about affording the service. SPC's put a big emphasis lately on helping students finish what they start. It's a big, big push for Dr. Law. Putting resources in place to ensure that they make it through to earn that degree or certificate that will truly change their lives. And we're getting very good at that. But we haven't forgotten that at our core, we're an open access institution, a four-year college in programs and stature, but still a community college in our hearts, serving our communities and making sure that students who would not otherwise have access to a quality higher education can do so close to home. Central to that access is the ability to attend class, and this agreement with PSTA for universal bus passes delivers on that promise. The dog may still eat your homework, but we're eliminating the dilemma of you not being able to get to class. Thanks again to CEO Brad Miller, PSTA CEO Brad Miller, to the county commissioners, to other public officials who have helped us with this process, and the PSTA board, and all the folks on the administration and staff of St. Petersburg College who have worked so hard over years to make this happen and make this agreement bring us to this point today. Our students and our communities are the winners. Now we're going to move this podium, and then we're going to get Dr. Law and our students and Mr. Miller up here, and we're going to have a formal ribbon cutting.